Responding with web pages is great, but sometimes all that needs to be communicated is information. For example, let's say that there's a web application out there called Yum that wants to collect our restaurant menus and advertise them to mobile clients based on their location. Free advertising, all right. This app wants to see the restaurants and menus available in our database, but doesn't really need to parse through HTML or waste bandwidth receiving CSS files. It just wants the data. For this reason, developers have created APIs, or application programming interfaces, that allow external applications to use public information our apps want to share, without all the bells and whistles. When an API is communicated over the internet following the rules of HTTP, we call this a RESTful API. One of the most popular ways of sending data with a RESTful architecture is with a format called JSON, which stands for JavaScript Object Notation. JSON uses attribute-value pairs, which are delimited by a colon. Brackets are used to encapsulate individual objects. Let's start coding to add this JSON feature to our application. Before we write the JSON function in our Flask menu app, let's first open up the database setup.py and add a decorator method. This serializable function will help define what data we want to send across and put it in a format that Flask can easily use. Flask has a built-in package called JSONify that will allow us to easily configure an API endpoint for our application. I will go ahead and import this package now in my project.py file. For this lesson, we are only going to focus on using a GET request to get a collection of restaurant menu items, but know that other types of requests can be implemented as well. I will now create a route similar to my restaurant menu page with /JSON at the end. I then create a function and name it restaurantMenuJSON, and then perform the same query as in my restaurant menu class. But instead of returning a template, I will return this JSONify class and use this loop to serialize all of my database entries. Now, if I save and go to localhost port 5000 /restaurant/1/menu/json, I'm returned with the pure data form of my menu in a format that can easily be read by humans and easily parsed by other computers.